Ali Imdad. Might know him from... Oh yeah, please, do you have a moment? So I guess you've already seen him before, but just a quick intro. Ali was part of the Great British Bake Off in 2013, and I'm sure we all know him, and has a fantastic, fantastic bakery place in Birmingham called Artisan, which I just went to last week. I'd highly recommend it. You should definitely go there. And Ali's going to be making a chicken salad for us.
Yes, so it's a chicken salad, but it's not a boring chicken salad. It's kind of Middle Eastern flavoured. So it's a chicken salad, but it's a little bit different. To start with, I've got some chicken thighs. I'm just going to put it into a... Can you guys see? Just over there. Okay, I have a confession to make. I didn't quite come prepared when I came today. I kind of forgot I was doing a demo this early. So just before I came here, I ran to the co-op around the corner. And I thought, what shall I make today? What shall I make? And I thought, I know what. I'll make a chicken salad. And so yeah.
It's true actually, because he did come around the back and say, where's my chicken?
Okay, so I'm going to marinate it with a little bit of oil. A little bit of ground coriander. Now, I do want to point out that all this chicken salad is healthy for you. I'm not doing it for this whole sort of clean eating market. I'm doing it just because we're all going to eat something really fattening out there. I know I am. So this gives it a good balance.
Clean eating nonsense, huh?
Clean eating nonsense, yeah.
I guess because you're a baker.
No, it's not just because I'm a baker. It's because it is nonsense. There's no scientific evidence at all to support clean eating. Healthy eating is different. If you want to be healthy. But don't do this, I'm going to cut out sugar, I'm going to cut out carbs, and don't cut anything out.
So that was chili powder?
That's a little bit of chili powder, and some paprika. Basically, I'm trying to be inspired by a combination of Mediterranean and Moroccan. So that's kind of where this chicken salad is going. Some paprika. And as always, handling chicken.
Well, there's two things.
Just coriander, I've already coriander. Chicken's a bit bigger than my face.
I think
you're
supposed to cook a bit like your mom's style, where you just put it up.
You know what? Cooking and baking is very different. Baking is like a science, it's very precise. But cooking is like, it's very forgiving. You know, kind of go on your smell, go on taste. It's quite difficult to get things wrong in cooking.
That's good.
Okay, so I'm going to start grilling my chicken. Sort of figure out how this works.
It looks like it.
Okay, we have something.
So we're at 6 out of 9 on heat.
I would normally do it like low 3, but I don't think people want to wait around 25 minutes to see chicken cook. Okay. I've been walking around though, I've had some really good food places. I haven't. I got here about 10, and then I have a stall as well outside, so I've been sitting at my stall for about an hour. And then I was just at my stall now, and then I looked at the time, it was 12:15, and I realized I had to get my off and top them up. And they make delicious food on those salads. But co-op didn't have any of them, so we can tortillas.
Improvisation.
This is carry out.
And this is just like a wrap.
A wrap.
We're trying to clean up a bit.
Thank you. Okay, what next? Okay, so now my thing on top. My chicken. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to slice it. You know what? I should check if the chicken's cooked first, shouldn't I?
Oh, that's a good idea.
I don't want to poison anyone.
Yeah,
I have to drive up from burning. Is it burning? Sweet and savoury thing. Well, like the savoury, it has to be savoury.
Yeah.
But I love sweetness in my savoury.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe not knock off in 15 minutes. That is yum.
It's interesting.
Good job.
I want to do this anyway.